distribution of load between power plants. So we have studied how loads can be economically distributed between different units within a power plant. So now we have to study how the total load in a power system network can be economically distributed between different power plants. So total nammada power system ile load power plants ne distribute cheyanam. Appo ore plant ne kittuna load aanu pinneedu aa plant in agathulla units ne distribute cheyunnu. ഈ രണ്ടാമത് പറഞ്ഞ കാര്യം നമ്മൾ ഓൾറെഡി ചെയ്തു കഴിഞ്ഞു. സോ നൗ വി ഹാവ് ടു സ്റ്റഡി ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷൻ ഓഫ് ലോഡ് ഇൻ എ പവർ സിസ്റ്റം നെറ്റ്വർക്ക് ബിറ്റ്വീൻ ദ പവർ പ്ലാന്റ്സ്. സോ കൺസിഡർ എ പവർ സിസ്റ്റം നെറ്റ്വർക്ക് വിത്ത് എൻ നമ്പർ ഓഫ് പവർ പ്ലാന്റ്സ്. ലെറ്റ് പി വൺ പി ടു എക്സെട്ര പി എൻ ബി ദ ജനറേഷൻ ഓഫ് ഈച്ച് പ്ലാന്റ്. ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ദ പവർ ഔട്ട്പുട്ട് ഓഫ് ഈച്ച് പ്ലാന്റ് ആർ പി വൺ പി ടു എക്സെട്ര പി എൻ. PD is the total demand in the power system network and PL is the transmission loss occurring in the transmission line. C1 of P1, C2 of P2, etc. CN of PN denotes the fuel cost of each of the power plant. So the C1 of P1, C1 is the fuel cost of plant 1, which is a function of the power generation of that particular plant. So that is why it is written as C1 of P1. C1 a function of P1. So likewise up to CN of PN. By economic load dispatch, our aim is to find out the generation of each plant, that is power output of each plant, P1, P2, etc. PN, so that total fuel cost is minimum. So നമുക്ക് PD എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഡിമാൻഡിനെ സപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യണം, അത്രയും പവറിനെ സപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യണം. അങ്ങനെ ചെയ്യണമെങ്കിൽ ഓരോ പ്ലാന്റും എത്ര പവർ ഔട്ട്പുട്ട് തരണം, P1, P2, P3, etc. PN എത്രയായിരിക്കും എന്ന് കണ്ടുപിടിക്കണം. സച്ച് ദാറ്റ് ടോട്ടൽ ഫ്യൂൽ കോസ്റ്റ് ഇസ് മിനിമം. ടോട്ടൽ ഫ്യൂൽ കോസ്റ്റ് മിനിമം ആവുന്ന രീതിയിൽ ഈ ഡിമാൻഡിനെ സപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യാൻ ഓരോ പ്ലാന്റും എത്ര പവർ ജനറേറ്റ് ചെയ്യണം, അത് കണ്ടുപിടിക്കുകയാണ് നമ്മുടെ എയിം. സോ ടോട്ടൽ ഫ്യൂൽ കോസ്റ്റ് ക്യാൻ ബി റിട്ടൺ ആസ് CT ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു C1 of P1 plus C2 of P2 plus etc. plus CN of PN. So this can be generalized as summation I is equal to 1 to N CI of PI. So I have discussed all these factors in the previous derivation. So here we have a function which is to be minimized. In linear programming problems, the functions which has to be minimized or maximized are known as objective functions. Objective function. So here total cost is our objective function and we have to minimize this. And this cannot be directly minimized. And there are certain constraints. And we can minimize this function only by considering these constraints. Constraints simply means limitations. ചില ലിമിറ്റേഷൻസ് ഉണ്ടായിരിക്കും നമ്മുടെ പ്രോബ്ലത്തിൽ, അതിനെ കൺസിഡർ ചെയ്തുകൊണ്ട് മാത്രമേ നമുക്ക് ഈ ഫംഗ്ഷനെ മിനിമൈസ് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റൂ. സോ ഹിയർ ദ കൺസ്ട്രെയിൻസ് ആർ, ഫസ്റ്റ് വൺ ഇസ് PI മിനിമം ലെസ് ദാൻ ഓർ ഈക്വൽ ടു PI ലെസ് ദാൻ ഓർ ഈക്വൽ ടു PI മാക്സിമം. സോ PI മീൻസ് ദ പവർ ജനറേഷൻ ഓഫ് ith പ്ലാന്റ്. സോ ഇറ്റ് ഷുഡ് ബി വിതിൻ എ മിനിമം ആൻഡ് മാക്സിമം ലിമിറ്റ്. സോ ഫോർ ഈച്ച് ഓഫ് ദി പവർ പ്ലാന്റ് ദർ വിൽ ബി എ മിനിമം ആസ് വെൽ ആസ് എ മാക്സിമം ലിമിറ്റ് for the power generation. And the value that we are calculating, that is PI, should be within that minimum and maximum limit. So this constraint is known as the inequality constraint. As it is represented with inequality symbols, this is known as the inequality constraint. And second constraint is the total load demand plus total loss should be equal to P1 plus P2 plus etc. PN. That means the generation, the total generation, the sum of power output of the plants should be equal to the total load demand plus power loss in the transmission line. So this is the, so here comes the difference. So in the previous derivation, the total load demand equals total generation. So we didn't have considered the power loss there while we were deriving the expression for economic load dispatch between units within a power plant we don't have to consider the transmission loss. So there the equation was PD is equal to P1 plus P2 plus etc. plus PN. So in case of economic load dispatch between different power plants, there will be transmission lines and we have to consider the transmission loss. So this transmission loss has to be supplied by the power plants. So ഇവിടെ ടോട്ടൽ ലോഡ് ഡിമാൻഡ് മാത്രമല്ല നമ്മുടെ പവർ പ്ലാന്റ്സ് സപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യേണ്ടത്. അപ്പോൾ ട്രാൻസ്മിഷൻ ലൈൻസിൽ ഉണ്ടാകുന്ന പവർ ലോസും കൂടി നമ്മുടെ പവർ പ്ലാന്റ്സ് വേണം സപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യാൻ. സോ ഔട്ട്പുട്ട് ഓഫ് ദ പവർ പ്ലാന്റ്സ്, സം ഓഫ് ജനറേഷൻ ഓഫ് ഓൾ ദ പ്ലാന്റ്സ് ഷുഡ് ബി ഈക്വൽ ടു ടോട്ടൽ ലോഡ് ഡിമാൻഡ് പ്ലസ് ടോട്ടൽ പവർ ലോസ്. സോ ദിസ് ക്യാൻ ബി റിട്ടേൺ ആസ് PD plus PL minus P1 plus P2 plus etc. PN equal to 0. So this term can be written as generalized as summation I is equal to 1 to N PI equal to 0. So this is known as the equality constraint. PD plus PL minus summation I is equal to 1 to N PI is equal to 0. So for the time being, we will consider only the equality constraint and will solve the problem. So omitting, by avoiding the inequality constraint, our problem can be written as minimize the total cost CT is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to N CI of PI subject to the equality constraint, that is PD plus PL minus summation I is equal to 1 to N PI is equal to 0. So now, as in the previous case, this problem can be solved by using the method of Lagrangian multipliers. So for that, form a Lagrangian function by augmenting the objective function and the equality constraint using the Lagrangian multiplier lambda. So augmenting means simply connecting. So form a Lagrangian function L, which will be equal to the objective function plus lambda into the equality constraint. So here the Lagrangian function will be a function of variables p1, p2, etc., pn. So here I is equal to 1 to n. So here comes the variables p1, p2, etc., pn, and also the Lagrangian multiplier lambda. So L will be a function of p1, p2, etc., pn and lambda. So after forming the Lagrangian function, our problem becomes to minimize the Lagrangian function. So now we have to minimize the Lagrangian function. So now, conditions for minimum for any function, the condition for a minimum is first derivative of that function with respect to all the variables equal to 0. Conditions for minimum are first derivative equal to 0. So the function should be differentiated with all the variables and it should be equated to 0. So here the Lagrangian function is a function of a number of variables. So we cannot take total derivative here. So we have to go for partial differentiation. So the variables are p1, p2, etc., pn. So differentiate L with respect to all these variables. So this can be generally written as dou L by dou PI equal to 0 for I is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc., n. That is dou L by dou P1, dou L by dou P2, etc., dou L by dou PN. And lambda is the other variable. So dou L by dou lambda should also be equated to 0. So now, for the ease of derivation, consider a plan with 2 units. So Lagrangian function is L of P1, P2, lambda is equal to C1 of P1 plus C2 of P2 plus lambda into PD plus PL minus P1 minus P2. So we have to consider partial derivative with respect to P1, P2 and lambda. So dou L by dou P1 equal to 0 implies, so derivative of this term with respect to P1. So dou C1 by dou P1, and P1 is also here. So lambda into, and also transmission loss PL. So we have already formulated the equation, expression for transmission loss. So transmission loss is a function of all the plant generations. Transmission loss as a function of plant generation. We have already formulated that expression. So PL is a function of P1, P2, etc. PN. So here PL is a function of P1 and P2. So we have to consider PL also while differentiating. So lambda into, lambda is a constant, lambda into dou PL by dou P1 minus derivative of P1 with respect to P1 is 1. So this is equation number 1. And dou L by dou P2 equal to 0 implies, so this is equal to 0. So dou L by dou P2 equal to 0 implies dou C2 by dou P2 plus lambda into dou PL by dou P2 minus derivative of P2 respect to P2 is 1. So which is also equal to 0. So now see equation numbers 1 and 2. We have to generalize these two equations. So here when we are differentiating with P1, the term is dou C1 by dou P1. So here it is dou C2 by dou P2. This is dou L by dou P1 and this is dou L by dou P2. So these two equations can be generalized as dou Ci by dou Pi plus lambda into dou PL by dou Pi minus 1 is equal to 0. So we can generalize equations 1 and 2 like this. Dou Ci by dou Pi plus lambda into dou PL by dou Pi minus 1 is equal to 0. So now, see the term dou Ci by dou Pi. So Ci is the fuel cost of plant I. So the fuel cost of plant I depends on the power generation of that plant only. That is, Ci depends on Pi only. The function Ci is a function of only one variable Pi. So we can replace the partial derivative by total derivative. That is, dou Ci by dou Pi is equal to dCi by dPi. എന്തുകൊണ്ടാണ് ith പ്ലാന്റിന്റെ കോസ്റ്റ് ith പ്ലാന്റിന്റെ പവർ ഔട്ട്പുട്ടിനെ മാത്രമേ ഡിപ്പെൻഡ് ചെയ്യത്തുള്ളൂ. അപ്പോൾ ഇവിടെ ഒരു വേരിയബിളേ ഉള്ളൂ. സോ വി ഡോണ്ട് ഹാവ് ടു ടേക്ക് ദ പാർഷ്യൽ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ്, വി ക്യാൻ ഡയറക്ട്ലി ടേക്ക് ടോട്ടൽ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ്. സോ റീപ്ലേസിംഗ് ദിസ് പാർഷ്യൽ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ് ബൈ ടോട്ടൽ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ്, ദ ഇക്വേഷൻ ബിക്കംസ് dCi by dPi plus lambda into dou PL divided by dou Pi minus 1 is equal to 0. ഇവിടെ ചേഞ്ച് ഒന്നുമില്ല. PL is a function of all the power generations. So here we have to use the partial derivative. From this equation, we can write dCi by dPi is equal to minus lambda into dou PL by dou Pi minus 1. So dCi by dPi is equal to, taking minus sign into the bracket, right hand side becomes lambda into 1 minus dou PL by dou Pi. So from here, lambda can be written as lambda is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus dou PL by dou Pi into dCi divided by dPi. That is, by taking this term into the left hand side, the equation becomes like this. So this equation can be written as Li into dCi by dPi is equal to lambda. That is, we have substituted Li instead of this term, 1 divided by 1 minus dou PL by dou Pi. So this equation, Li into dCi by dPi is equal to lambda, is known as coordination equation. Now, what is the value of Li? This term, 1 divided by 1 minus dou PL by dou Pi. So this term, Li, is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus dou PL by dou Pi, is known as penalty factor. So this term is also very important, penalty factor. So there is a frequently asked question from the A part is, what is penalty factor? So while we were deriving the transmission loss equation, so I have said that the question, what are B coefficients, will be regularly asked in the A part. Actually, that question is asked as, what are B coefficients and penalty factors? So this question, penalty factor, is usually being asked in the A part. So write penalty factor as Li is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus dou PL by dou PI. Thereafter, explain all the terms. So this is the important equation from this derivation. So that is, for the economic distribution of load between different plants in a power system network, the important equation that we need to know is the coordination equation. Li into dci by dpi is equal to lambda. So penalty factor is Li is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus dou pl by dou pi. And this term, dou pl divided by dou pi, is known as incremental transmission loss. Incremental transmission loss, dou pl divided by dou pa. So we know that the term dou ci by dou pi is the incremental cost. Similarly, dou pl by dou pi is the incremental transmission loss. Now, equation A can be written as, what is equation A? Li into dci by dpi is equal to lambda. So I can be 1, 2, 3, etc. up to n. So it can be written as L1 into dc1 by dp1 is equal to L2 into dc2 by dp2 is equal to etc. equal to Ln into dcn by dpn is equal to lambda. That is, for the total fuel cost to be minimum, the product of incremental fuel cost and penalty factor should be same for all the plants. So the condition for economic load dispatch or minimum fuel cost in the case of power plants is the product of penalty factor and incremental fuel cost should be same for all the plants, and it should be equal to lambda. Now we have to consider one more condition. So there is another condition for minimum that we have to consider. Dou L by dou lambda is equal to 0. So this was our function L. C1 of P1 plus C2 of P2 plus lambda into PD plus PL minus P1 minus P2. So differentiating Lagrangian function with respect to lambda, we'll get PD plus PL minus P1 minus P2 is equal to 0. So this equation. So this can be written as PD plus PL is equal to P1 plus P2. That is, total generation should be equal to total demand plus the total transmission loss. So this can be generalized as PD plus PL is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to N PI. And this equation is known as the power balance equation. So for solving problems related to economic load distribution between different power plants, you should know these two equations, the power balance equation and the coordination equation. Coordination equation, Li into dci by dpi is equal to lambda.